So we were solving
Yes, sir.
we were solving yeah who is this we were
Surojit.
Surojit, I will call you once again. For time being, mute yourself. I will
Okay,
call you
sir.
back. Yeah, so we were solving part A of the problem, that we had to find out the maximum speed of this collar as it is acted upon by the pin, as it is acted upon by the force P as shown in the diagram. Are you with me, Vedant?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so let us say that we are, as a first thing, we will find out maximum speed in the interval 0 to 2 seconds. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so in that case, if I consider a time interval t, at that time t, the value of p is equal to 5t. This we have already derived. Go distance 2, you get 10. So go distance t, you are going to get it as 5t. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And this 5t force can be assumed to be constant over a very small interval of time near duration t, between t to t plus dt. We can assume that the force p is constant during the interval t to t plus dt. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So on the left hand side, I have drawn the free body diagram of a block at instant t. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So there are two forces acting on the block. One is 4 pound and another one is 5t. Both the forces are in pounds. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let us apply now. And we know that the block started from zero initial velocity. So v0 is zero. That means velocity at time t equal to zero is zero. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Now let us apply impulse momentum principle from time 0 to t. So what does this principle say? Impulse of all the forces acting on a body from time 0 to t is equal to change in momentum from time 0 to t. So let us apply that. So what is the impulse of this 5t force? So we will assume that y axis upward is positive. There are no horizontal forces, there are no inclined forces. So we need not now write in terms of vector notations. All the impulses, they can be written simply in with positive or negative sign, depending upon whether the impulses are upward or downward. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what is the impulse of this 5T force? So it is going to be 5T dt. What is dt? Dt is the time over which this 5t force was acting. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And now to get the impulse of this p, p equal to 5t, hai na? So to get the impulse of this p from 0 to t, what I will have to do? I will have to integrate it from 0 to t. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So this is the impulse of p during time 0 to t, where t is less than 2 seconds. So we have to understand t is less than 2 seconds, less than equal to 2 seconds. It is positive because this force is directed in positive y direction. What about 4lb? How do I write it? Impulse 4 multiplied by t minus 0, that is t itself. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And its sign will be negative. This must be equal to change in momentum from 0 to t. That is, it must be equal to momentum at time t minus momentum at time 0. T equal to 0. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
But this velocity, initial velocity being 0, this term is going to vanish. And what you are going to get it as is m into vt. What is the mass of this block?
4 pounds.
4 pounds. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I think we have made a mistake in last problem, because you will have to understand that here I have substituted the forces in pounds, And here this mass I am substituting again in pound and multiplied by velocity at time t. ऐसे बोल रहा हूँ ना?
Yes sir.
So there will be unit mismatch. I will have to convert this into the unit of forces. So let us stick to the units which we are conversant with. So let us convert everything in kg. Did we do that in last part? Have we done that? Vedant?
No sir, I don't know sir.
You were there in the last class? No.
No sir.
Okay. So let me change this from pounds to kg. 1 minute. Pounds to kg. So 0.4535. I will have to multiply this by 0.4535. So I will multiply this phi t by 0.4535. This will give me P in kg, but I need P in terms of Newton. So I will multiply it by 9.81. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Similarly, here I am going to multiply it by 0.4535. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And then I am going to multiply it by 9.81. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And here also I will have to multiply it by 0.4535. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what is the integration of left hand side part? So let us do the integration. So it turns out to be 5 into 0.4535. Can be taken outside the integration sign. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And what is the integration of t? It is t square by 2. And when I substitute the upper and lower limit, it is going to remain t square by 2. Happy?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Then now what about this part? Minus 4 into 0.4535 into 9.81. This must be equal to 4 into 0.4535 into velocity at time t. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Now, so can I write down velocity at time t? Now, velocity at time t therefore will be divide each term by 4 into 0.4535. So 0.4535 will cancel throughout. You will agree with me. And what remains in the first term is 5 by 4 into 9.81 t square by 2. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And what remains in the second term is minus 9.81. Happy?
Yes, sir.
This must be equal to Vt. Now you can see that Vt is a function of time. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So if Vt and you have t here, so it will be 9.81 t. I'm sorry, I missed that t. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Now, Vt being function of t, Vt is now a function of t. If I want to get the maximum value of Vt, what should I have? dVt by dt must be zero. Condition for maxima. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
In fact, it is a condition for maxima and minima. That's all right. We have to look at second derivative to decide whether it is maxima or not. So second derivative negative means it is maxima. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
But we need not worry about that condition. That condition will automatically get satisfied. We will just say dvt by dt is equal to zero. So what is the derivative of first term here? Can you tell me? So it will be 2 into 5 by 4. Into 9.81 into t by 2. Do you agree with me? This is the derivative of first term. And minus 9.81 must be equal to 0. From this,
yes,
we are going to get the value of t. So can you tell me how much is t? Just do the calculation.
Yes, sir. Sir, just I guess it's
0 point.
8.
Okay. No mistakes, right? Cross verify yes, once.
Yes, sir. It's correct.
Okay. So it is 0.8 seconds. Now we will substitute this t equal to 0.8 seconds in this expression, and you will get maximum speed during time interval 0 to 2. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So that is how much? Tell me, substitute t equal to 0.8 here. So 5/4 into 9.81 into 0.8 square by 2 minus 9.81 into 0.8. Yeah, how much did you get?
Yes, sir, just calculating. Sir, it's coming out to be
8.3. Okay, yes, just no, I'm looking at something different. 5/4 into 9.81 into 0.8 square by 2 minus 9.81 into 0.8. No, I'm getting it as minus 3.924. Other speed
the same.
Minus 3.924.
Yes, sir.
So meter per, this is in meter per second, because we have converted this unit system into SI1. And as it is negative, therefore this speed, it must be downward. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Now this is the maximum speed in the time interval 0 to 2 seconds. Now let us try to find out what is the maximum speed in the interval 2 to 3 seconds. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So maximum speed in the interval 2 to 3 seconds, 2 seconds to 3 seconds. For that, I will take this graph down as it is. And we are now going to apply. We are going to apply impulse momentum principle from. Now, mind you, here I cannot write t as phi t, because t will be equal to phi t from 0 to 2 seconds. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So this phi t is applicable only from 0 to 2 seconds. And then it will be 10 lb from 2 to 3 seconds. Agreed?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
So this is how the p varies. So how are we going to write down the impulse momentum principle? Now I will call this as t star and dt star. And we have to write down the impulse momentum principle now up to time t, which lands in the zone 2 to 3. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So how do we write that? So now, how do we apply the impulse momentum principle? So let us apply it. Impulse of P, how do we write? So 5t star dt star. Star is just represents that it is one variable, nothing else. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
This we will have to integrate from 0 to 2. So this will give me the impulse of P from 0 to 2 seconds. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Plus 10 into t minus 2 seconds. This is the impulse from 2 to t seconds. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
This is from 0 to 2. And this is the impulse from 2 to impulse of p from 2 to 3 seconds. I hope you have understood how I have written this. We have done this even in the previous class. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what is the impulse of 4LB4? And of course, we have to multiply it by 0.4535. 0.4535. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And then we have to multiply it by 9.81. So here also I will have to multiply it by 0.4535. Then I will have to multiply it by 9.81. This is to convert everything into Newton. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And then this, what is the impulse of 4LB4? So it will be this will be plus, this will be minus, and that is 4 into 0.4535. 0.4535 converts LB into kg, multiplied by 9.81, it converts kg into Newton, multiplied by T. Happy?
Yes, sir.
This force is constant from 0 to T. So there is no nothing like in finding out the impulse from 0 to 2 seconds and then from 2 to T seconds. No, it is constant. So we can directly write down its impulse up from 0 to 2 T seconds. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And then what is the value? How do I write the right hand side will remain as it is. So right hand side is going to be 4 into 0.4535 into Vt. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
4 into 0.4535 into velocity at time t. So how do I write velocity at time t? Tell me. See, 0.4535 is going to cancel throughout.
Yes, sir.
And I will have to divide the right hand side by 4. So the first term is going to be 1, means I will take 1 by 4 common. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And the first term will be 5 t star square by 2. But when I substitute the upper limit, it will be 5 into 2 square by 2. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So 5 into 2 square by 2 multiplied by 9.81. Happy?
Yes, sir.
This is the first term. What about the second term? Second term is going to be equal to 10 into 9.81. 10 into 9.81. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Multiplied by t minus 2. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And what about the third term? Third term, it is going to be equal to minus 4 into 9.81 t.
Yes, sir.
Happy?
Yes, sir.
This 1 by 4 is sitting outside everything. Now just observe this expression. We have to get the maximum value of Vt. So how do I get the maximum of Vt? So let us try and observe this value for at time t equal to 2 seconds. At time t equal to 2 seconds, what is going to be the value? This term is going to vanish. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
By the way, this expression is valid from 2 seconds to 3 seconds. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So at time t equal to 2 seconds, this term is going to vanish. Happy?
Yes, sir.
This term vanishes. And what happens to this term? This term will be equal to 4 into 9.81 into 2, whatever it is.
Yes, sir.
Can we further simplify this? Can you help me simplifying this? So what is this value? 2 square becomes 4. 4, 4 cancels out. So 5 by 2 into 9.81. How much is that? Tell me.
So,
5 by 2 into 9.81.
So 24.5.
What about this? 10 into 10 by 4 in 10 by 4 is 2.5. So 2.5 into 9.81. How much is that? Same, I guess.
Same, yes, sir.
So 24.5. And here I am going to have it as P minus 2. Agreed?
Yes, sir. Yes.
And minus
9.81.
Yeah. So tell me 9.81. Happy?
Yes, now,
what is dvt by dt? This is equal to 24.5. Right?
Yes, sir.
Minus 9.81. Do you agree with me?
24.5 will be not there. It is constant.
Yes, sir.
24.5?
It will
no, 24.5 t.
This 24.5 is constant, but you have 24.5 times t, no?
Okay, sir. Okay.
So 24.2 minus 9.81. So that means dv by dt is never going to be zero. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Never zero. So that means there is no local maxima or minima in 2 to 3 seconds. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So what should we do? So let us try to find out what is velocity at t equal to 2 seconds. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So at t equal to 2 seconds, the second term is going to vanish. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And what is 9.81 into 2? Tell me.
19.6.
And what is 24.5 minus 19.6?
Four point nine meter per second.
Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And what is velocity at t equal to 3 seconds? Tell me. So this term becomes 1, so it will be 24.5 plus 24.5, that is 49. 49 minus 9.81 into 3. Tell me how much is that? So how much is that?
19.5
meter per second. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So which is the maximum out of these two? This one. So here the graph of velocity from time t equal to 2 seconds to time t equal to 3 seconds is going to be linear. And therefore you did not get any maxima or minima. It is not something like this where you will get this as a maxima. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So velocity is maximum at 3 seconds in 2 to 3 second interval. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And in 0 to 2 seconds, when was it maximum? What is the value of maximum velocity? It is minus 3.924. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Which one is magnitude wise greater amongst two? This one. So therefore we can say that V max is maximum of maximas in two intervals, and therefore it is going to be 19.5 meter per second. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So this is the maximum speed that the object can have. Only speed is asked, so we will not talk about the direction. But we know that as it is positive, therefore it is upward. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this was the solution of problem number 77. Now can you read problem number 78 for me?
Yes, sir. The triple jump is a track and field event in which an athlete gets a running start and tries to leap as far as he can with a hop, step and jump. Shown in the figure, the initial hop of the athlete, assuming the approaches the takeoff line from the left, with a horizontal velocity of 10 meter per second remains in contact with the ground for 0.18 seconds and take off angle is 50 degrees with a velocity of 12 meter per second determine the vertical component of average impulsive force extended by the ground on his foot. Give your answer in terms of weight W of athlete.
Okay, so interesting question. So for this, let me share a small video with you all. 1 minute. Is my screen visible? Vedant, is my screen visible?
Sir, it's showing starting to share content.
Now?
That's still the same.
Still the same.
Yes, sir.
No one is able to see the screen?
Yes, sir. No, sir.
Okay, just give me a second. Is my screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so just give me a second. Is the video visible?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay, so let us observe how does this triple jump go. So this is the initial stretch where he runs, then takes off two times, and then this is the entire recording of the triple jump. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so now let me stop sharing 1 minute and let us go back to the problem. Yeah, so is this screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is the event t equal to zero at which he is about to leave the contact with the ground. That means he is about to jump for the first time. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what is the data that is being given? So let us read the problem. The triple jump is track and field event in which the athlete goes on running and starts and tries to leap as per that's all that's okay. Shown in the figure is the initial hop of the athlete. Assume that. Just give me a second. Somebody is trying to join the class. Yeah. So assume that he approaches the takeoff line from the left. From the left, with a horizontal velocity of 10 meter per second. So he's at time t equal to zero when he is just about to jump for the first time. His velocity is 10 meter per second. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And he remains in the contact with the ground for 0.18 seconds. So once he reaches this line, he remains in the contact with the ground till the time he generates the force to take off. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And what is that time? That time is 0 to 0.18 seconds. Happy?
Yes, sir.
So what happens at 0.18 second? At time t equal to 0, his velocity is horizontal 10 meter per second. And at time t equal to 0.18 second, his velocity is inclined at an angle of 50 degree with 12 meter per second. So how does this velocity change? Because he has generated a jumping force here. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And takes off at an angle of 50 degree with the velocity of 12 meter per second. So though for showing they have shown that this jump has occurred at different points, actually it is happening at the same point. After 0.18 second, he would have the velocity of 12 meter per second at an angle of 50 degree. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And what is asked, determine the vertical component of average impulsive force exerted by ground on his foot. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
तो कौन सा कंपोनेंट पूछा है? सिर्फ वर्टिकल कंपोनेंट पूछा है. The horizontal component has not been asked. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So how are we going to solve this problem? So we are going to apply obviously impulse momentum principle. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
From time t equal to zero, that means when he has just reached the line, red line, takeoff line, to t equal to 0.18 second. So when he has just taken off. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And what is the information that is available with us? Information available with us is his velocity at time t equal to zero, v at zero is equal to 10. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And I'm going to call it as 10 I cap. Why I cap? Because it is along x direction, positive x direction. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
And what is his velocity at time t equal to 0.18 second? Tell me. It is 12 cos 50 I cap. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Plus 12 sin 50 j cap. I hope you agree with me.
Yes, sir.
This is the velocity after time t equal to 0.18 seconds. And we are applying impulse momentum principle during this time. Obviously, we need to draw the free body diagram. Are you with me? So what? Yes, how does the free body diagram look like? Chalo. So what we will do is, let us draw the free body diagram. So there is his self weight. How much is his self weight?
W.
So that self weight, I'm going to show it as W here. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And the ground is going to offer two reactions on the foot. Konse reactions hai? One is vertical reaction offered by the ground. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So I will call it as VG. So what is VG? Vertical reaction offered by the ground. And to jump forward, he is pushing the ground backward. So ground will push him forward. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So second reaction that is offered will be horizontal reaction by the ground. Why it is towards right? Because to jump forward, he is pushing the ground back. So by Newton's third law, ground must be pushing him front forward. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So that is shown as horizontal reaction offered by the ground. Now, can you tell me let me apply impulse momentum principle. So how do I apply that? So what is the impulse of this force W? Tell me. W into 0.18 second minus zero, because I am applying the impulse momentum principle from 0 to 0.18 second. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And this impulse is in which direction? It is in y direction, but negative y direction. So can I call it as minus j cap?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. What is the impulse of force Vg? Tell me. Vg multiplied by 0.18 j cap. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Happy?
Yes, sir.
Okay. What is impulse of force Hg? Tell me. Hg multiplied by 0.18. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Into I cap. Because this impulse is in positive x direction. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
This must be equal to change in momentum. So mv at 0.18 second minus mv at 0 seconds. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Now what is the mass? It is going to be W by G or W upon 9.81. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So W upon 9.81 into velocity at 0.18. So what is the velocity at 0.18 seconds? 12 cos 50 I cap. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Plus 12 sin 50 J cap. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So 12 cos 50 I cap plus 12 sin 50 J cap is the velocity at 0.18 second. And what is the velocity at 0 seconds, time t equal to 0 seconds? That is 10 I cap. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Now, if left hand side and right hand side has to be equal, I need to equate coefficients of I cap and J cap. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
So let us first equate coefficients of I cap. So what do I get? Hg into 0.18. Happy? Must be equal to W upon 9.81 into 12 cos 50 minus W upon 9.81 into 10. Do you agree with me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So can you tell me how much is this? Hg will be equal to how much?
Yes, just
0.18 se divide karna hai. So it is 12 cos 50 upon 9.81 by 0.18. So I will take W common here. And this is 12 cos 50 divided by 0.18 minus 10 by 9.81 into 0.18. And here also you have 9.81. Yeah. So can you tell me how much is that?
Minus 1.29.
Minus?
Yes, sir.
No, that's how can it be minus? So what has happened?
Sir, the 12 cos 50 minus 10 gives
No. We have forgotten this minus sign here. There goes. No.
No, sir. G will be positive.
Just a minute. Hg yes, where are we going wrong? W minus W into point J cap, that's correct. Vg into 0.18 J cap, that is correct. And Hg into 0.18 I cap, that is also correct. Now velocity has changed from, okay, so W No, from where this W upon 9.81 into 10 I cap came?
Yes. Then it's
one minute. W upon 9.81. Yes, it is velocity at time t equal to 0, right?
Yes, sir.
So it is 10 I cap. That is also correct. So minus 10 I cap. So what is okay? So hg into 0.18. Okay, so we are equating the coefficients of I cap. So hg into 0.18, that's correct. Here I get the coefficient as 12 cos 50. Okay. That may be right. What is the value of 12 cos 50? Tell me.
12 cos 50. Just give me a moment, sir. 7.71.
So this 10 meter per second, its horizontal component has reduced. We gave this dimension on the basis that the horizontal component of velocity is increasing. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
But it has reduced, so it's all right. So we will get a negative sign. So tell me, how much is that? Hg is equal to how much?
Sir, just give me a moment.
12 cos 50 upon 0.18 into 9.81 minus 10 upon 9.81 into point.
It's minus 1.29.
Minus
1.29.
1.29 times W. That's all right. Therefore, it is towards left. Happy?
Yes, sir.
And now if I equate the coefficients of J cap, I am going to get the vertical component of reaction. So what is the J component on left hand side? It is 0.18 into Vg. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
0.18 into Vg. And then you have minus 0.18 into W. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
And on the right hand side, what do you have? So J components means 12 sine 50 W upon 9.81. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So it is 12 sine 50 into W upon 9.81. Take this on the other side. So I get Vg is equal to 1 upon 0.18. Happy?
Yes, sir.
Into 12 sine 50 upon 9.81 plus 0.18 outside the bracket W. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
So can you tell me how much is this? So Vg is equal to how many times W?
6.20.
6.20
times W.
Yeah. So the athlete has to apply a vertical force of 6.2 times his weight to achieve this change in velocity. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this was what the problem was about. Now we are going to solve one more problem, and that is going to be based on the impact. So the theory of impact we already covered in the previous class. Do you remember during the lab sessions? Do you remember that? Vedant, you were there for that?
No, sir. No, sir.
Okay. So please go through the recording. I don't know if I have shared that. Have I shared the recording?
No, sir.
Okay. So I will share the lab recording, and you will go through the lab recording for understanding of impact. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Tomorrow's class is going to be last one, and we may have an extended class tomorrow of 2 hours. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
That will be the last class of mechanics lectures. So with this, we will stop for today. If anyone has any doubt, please raise it. Otherwise, you can leave the class.